We're going to record this part. Okay, I was checking in with all our guides on what best way to do a past life regression. So I'm going to tell you, the normal way you do a past life regression is you want to get the person's energetic frequency, the client, in this case, you all are my client, to become very, very high. So you'll notice the majority of past life regressions begin with a guided spirit journey. The typical one is you start in a garden or a meadow and you look around you, you utilize all the senses. So you're like looking around at all the beauty, you bring the details of the flowers, you feel the breeze on your skin, you feel the sun coming down and how hot it gets, and then the clouds come between the sun and you have a moment of coolness, and then the clouds drift away, becomes a little hotter again, the breeze comes and cools you. So you're working with senses, you work with the aroma, sound, you see a little deers over here, bunny rabbits over here, birds in a tree over here. You might walk past an apple tree and pick an apple and eat it. As you're walking through the garden, you find yourself on a path that goes through a meadow that turns into wildflowers. The path becomes increasingly more natural, uneven. It takes you across a creek that you need to like hop over, or there might be a little bridge going over it. You go into the woods. You're walking through the path through the woods that become increasingly more ancient. And, you know, the whole time enticing all senses, sound, sight, smell, emotions. And then you come to like a cliff and you might walk down the cliff, down a path to a lake. It's common at that point to have like, there's a cottage there and there's a little bench and someone you knew in life who has passed is there and talks with you. Or you might, as they go down the cliff, have them go on a path and to go up another cliff or a stairwell or down a deeper stairwell. There's a hole and you go down. Either way, you're taking them on a journey and you either go very, very deep down or very, very high up. So you're taking them away from the frequency of here and now to a different resonance. Take them to a place where there's usually like a hallway with a bunch of doors. And as you approach a door, you look at it and what you see may be indicative of the life that you lived behind it. So it might be an ancient Greek door or a pirate boat door or whatever. And so you pick whichever door is calling to you. It's the one that you put your hand on, open the door, you go through, you're in the life. So this is the normal past life regression meditation. You can also do a variation on it to go to the Akashic Library. So I say this because I want you all to be able to, anytime you wish, do a past life regression. Normally, past life regressions are about 40 minutes to an hour of journeying to get the frequency where you want it, and then 10 minutes of past life. But now that you understand about the frequency, and we've been working with frequencies and how to connect with them, know that I often will do a past life regression, the full thing within 5 minutes, because once you have that frequency, you can just jump in it or pull it into you. You don't need to do the full meditation every time. Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. Okay. So we are going to be a little quicker on getting to the frequency we need, because what I'd like to do is visit several past lives. And I want your attention, you know, I want us to spend more time there and less time on the journey. You guys up for that? Yes. Okay. Excellent. Invite your bodies to relax. Give your feet permission to relax and flow with energy. And give the top of your head permission to relax and flow with energy. Invite this energy to fill your body and flow all through your being, emanate from you, as though you're a beautiful light bulb of love and divine kindness. Invite this beautiful love to flow into your body, fill you, flow into all of your internal nooks and crannies. If there are any areas in your body that are below the frequency of love and the highest level of self-value, honor these shards or elements. Invite them to receive love. Invite them to receive kindness, gratitude, and allow them to resonate or respond as they wish. And then allow yourself to resonate and flow, filling, flowing with love. Call out to your higher self, your soul self, to come and join you in this beautiful space. You'll notice your soul self has just been there waiting for this invitation, and your soul easily flows in through your crown and joins you, returning to your delicious, beautiful body. How fun for your soul, your entire spiritual being, to be able to resonate in physical shape. What a treat. Allow yourself a moment to let your energies resonate with each other. Fully mesh as one. Your soul self has an invitation for you to rise up out of your body. Your soul self has some beautiful energies that is wrapping around the two of you. So that you may be held together as one, and there is no way to fall apart. And as your soul self spins and twines and wraps beautiful energies of love around the two of you, binding the two of you together for this journey, your soul self rises up out of your body, bringing you along, rising up your hara line, up, up, up higher, along this beautiful line of light. You may feel as though you're rising up through a tunnel or a conduit. You may feel like you were a cosmic aerialist, rising up in the silken love cloths, the sheets of light and divine love, ever flowing. You are rising up out of this room, through the sky, up through the clouds, through the atmosphere, the hemisphere, wrapped together with your soul self, you are rising up through the cosmos, the galaxy. You look down and you see many galaxies beneath you as you rise up through the universe. And above the universe, through the dimensions, the frequencies, the multiple realities, rising ever upward through shifting elements of existence and being. Outside of time and space, rising ever upward, rising back to the bardo, to the twilight realm, to the land between all times and space, through reality, through between physical and spiritual, the place of total neutrality, where all can exist between all things. You arrive in the twilight realm with your higher self, surrounded by the love of the two of you. You may continue with the two of you as one being, or you may separate to two aspects of being. Whichever feels most comfortable for you is the perfect emanation for now. Here in the twilight realm, where it is eternally neutral, and all things may exist or not exist, all realms connect with this place. Whomever or whatever you call to you is contracted on the highest soul level to appear. You and your soul, the soul who is the connection to all of your past lives and all your time before life, all of your time between lives, your soul is the one constant being who has been there, who has helped you plan every life, who has helped you manage every life, who has sent other aspects of your soul to guide you through each life. You and your soul self call together, doorway to life. Come to me now. I call you, I beckon you. Come before me here, now, in the twilight realm. And you walk forward. Ahead of you is a doorway. Notice this doorway. What does it look like? Put your hand to this doorway. What does it feel like? Is there a temperature to it, to the touch? Is there any vibration? Does it feel smooth or rough? Is there decoration? or elements of nature? Is there a door frame or any aspect of surrounding wall? Do you smell anything or hear anything? Do you sense anything? What emotions are naturally rising up within you as you are here with this door? When you are ready, with the help of your soul self supporting you, either within you or beside you, either twined to you, holding hands or sharing space. When you are ready, open the door with your soul self, walk in through the door. Give yourself a moment once through to recalibrate, to allow your senses to start filtering in. You may already be fully in place and time, or you may have one sense awakening slowly after another. Allow yourself to resonate, calibrate, become one with where you are. You may be having a three-dimensional visual auditory experience, or you may have a sense of feeling. You may be reading something or hearing something. Whatever information is coming into you, receive it, acknowledge it, and allow it to take its form and shape. Invite your higher self, your soul self, to support you. As you go forward with your life, as you go forward, you may find yourself jumping through time or stuck in a time. You may find yourself in the body of that life or floating above. You may find yourself just absorbing the energy of that life, or hearing it on a radio program. However the information is coming to you, go forward with the support of your higher self, step into your life, you may ask yourself, how old are you at this moment? Are you male or female? What sort of environment are you? Where do you live? Ask yourself, when is this life? Are you wealthy or poor? What is your position in this society? With the support of your soul, go forward. Explore this life. In whatever way the exploration comes into you, accept it with gratitude and allow it to expand. If you'd like, you may move forward in time to another life experience with this life. If you have questions, you can ask the life that you're experiencing, ask your soul. Move on forward to your final moments in this life. Allow yourself to experience the final moments and your death. As this life has come to finish, ask the life that you've just had, what was our purpose for this life? Why were we in this life? What lessons was I to learn? This life, why are you sharing yourself with me now? Thank your life for having shared this experience with you. And then both of you, with your soul, may rise back up to the bardo, the twilight realm, together. Where everything is neutral, there is a total state of peace. And watch as this life is absorbed back into your soul state, your higher self. You and your higher self turn again to the doorway and notice how it has changed. Look upon it because it has behind it another life that you have lived. Look at the door. What does it look like now? This magical Akashic doorway. What sort of timeline does it belong to? What material is it made from? Is there any aroma? Do you feel, put your hand to the door and feel it. What does it feel like? Now open the door, and with the support of your higher self, both of you will go through to the other side, to a life that you have lived. Once through the doorway, give yourself a moment to adjust, recalibrate, invite your senses to absorb the experience as they're able to. Whatever information you receive, acknowledge it and receive it. This experience may be different from the last. Whatever senses are activated, invite them to continue. You may see, feel, and hear everything as though you're there, or you may be reading something or hearing a story being told to you or receive a download or just have an emotion. Whatever you receive, acknowledge it and accept it as you go forward into your past life. Where are you at this place? Are you male or female? How old are you at this moment? How do you feel? Do you feel hale and hearty, ill, in pain? Do you know, are you wealthy or poor? Is money even an issue in this life? How do you fit in with your culture? Ask your life to share an adventure with you. As you move forward in this life, how do you feel? Allow time to continue to the next stage of this life. Continue to your final time, your death time of this life. But when the soul aspect of this life departs the body of this life, you, your soul, and this life will stay there. Do not rise up, stay there. So continue to the death. As this life completes and your soul of this life rises up, invite this life to join you and your higher self to go back again and review the life path this life has taken compared to the life path it had planned to take. The three of you go back and quickly move through the life, mapping where the actual life was with or went away from the planned life. Where people who were in your life were on or off of their life paths, and how that affected you. Review your life path. Review it together. Look at the life lessons you came here to learn compared to the life lessons you actually learned. If there were any karmic lessons incomplete with this life, ask when and how many lives, or in which lives, they were finally completed. Ask the self of this life, what was their greatest happiness? What brought them the most joy? What do they most value of this life? Ask this life how and why they are connected to you in your life. Now time to say farewell to this life, and the three of you will rise back up to the bardo, the twilight realm, the place of total neutrality and absolute peace, as you return to the twilight realm. The life that you lived here absorbs back into your higher self. Your higher self turns to you, gives you a loving embrace with pride and gratitude and appreciation for the extraordinary person that you are in this life. And when look to the door of the bardo, you see it is the door to return back to this life, to this room, to your body here. And as you open the door and walk through, you return into yourself. You return to this room and this space. But you can feel your higher self is still flowing down through your crown. Your connection is eternal. You can invite your soul self back in anytime you wish. Allow yourself the time you need to return to your physical body, filling your being with your soul and your energy. Allow your toes and legs, fingers, arms, shoulders, your being to readjust, to become yourself once more.